Hello everyone. Today our topic of discussion is the covalent compounds. First of all, we will see covalent bond. The bond which is formed between the atoms by the mutual sharing of electrons is known as covalent bond. And the resulting compounds are known as covalent compounds. The bond which is formed by mutual sharing of electrons, the electrons which have 3, 4 and 5 electrons in its valence shell and does not have the ability to donate or gain electrons, they prefer the sharing of electrons to complete their octet. So they form covalent bonds. For example, the covalent bonds in CH4 methane molecule, we will see hydrogen has to complete its duplet and carbon has to complete its octet. Carbon has 4 electrons in its valence shell and hydrogen has 1 electron in its valence shell. So they prefer to share their electrons with each other. Hydrogen share its one electron with the carbon to complete its duplet, and carbon share its 4 electrons with the 4 hydrogen atoms to complete its octet. So the resulting 4 covalent bonds are formed between the carbon and the hydrogen to form methane. Let us further see the types of the covalent bond. There are 3 main types of the covalent bond, which are represented as the single bond, the double bond and the triple bond. We will discuss them one by one. The single covalent bond, the bond in which each partner donate or share 1 electron, is called a single covalent bond. E.g. HCl, hydrogen and chlorine, they share 1 electron to form a single covalent bond between the hydrogen and the chlorine, and this single bond is denoted by single line between the molecules which are bonded to each other covalently. Hydrogen versus chlorine, they are bonded singly with each other. Double bond, double covalent bond, the bond in which each sharing partner share 2 electrons to form the bond is known as double covalent bond. For example, here we will see ethylene or ethene, in which each partner donates 2 electrons to form double covalent bond. It is denoted by double bar between the double bonded 2 atoms. Let us here see the electronic distribution between the bond atoms. Here is the carbon number 1, here is the carbon number 2. It has 4 electrons in its valence shell. It also has 4 electrons in its valence shell. They form double bond with each other. So they arrange themselves in this way. Carbon, 2 electrons, carbon, 2 electrons. Now they have 2 electrons shared, and there is the other. Here comes the hydrogen. And here comes the other hydrogen. So this is the bonding in the ethene molecule, which represents the double bond between the carbon-carbon atom. Now let us further see the triple bond between the atoms, triple covalent bond, the bond in which each sharing partner shared 3 electrons with each other is known as triple covalent bond. Let's see the triple covalent bond in nitrogen. Here nitrogen has 5 electrons in its valence shell. So this is nitrogen. It has 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So other nitrogen will come here. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now there is a triple covalent bond between the 2 hydrogen atoms and their octets are complete. Classification of covalent bond. What is the classification of covalent bond? Covalent bonds are classified as polar and non-polar covalent bonds. What is the polar covalent bond and what is the non-polar covalent bond? Let us discuss them one by one. Non-polar covalent bond. The covalent bond formed between the same atoms with the same electronegativity value are known as non-polar covalent bonds, which have the same electronegativity value and the bonded atoms are same, is known as non-polar covalent bond. For example, the bond between the 2 chlorine atoms, the bond between 2 fluorine atoms, the bond between 2 hydrogen atoms, CTC, is known as non-polar covalent bond. The electrons are equally shared between the bonded atoms. The electrons are equally shared, nor attracted toward one. For non-polar covalent bond, the electronegativity difference should be 0.4 or less. The electronegativity difference between the two bonded atoms should be less than 0.4 or 0.4, not more than 0.4. If the electronegativity difference is more than 0.4, the bond will be polar. Now we will discuss the polar covalent bond. What is the polar covalent bond? The covalent bond formed between the different atoms with different electronegativity values are called as polar covalent bonds. For example, hydrogen chloride, hydrogen fluoride, H2O, these are the polar covalent bonds. The electrons are attracted towards the more electronegative atom. For polar covalent bonds, the electronegativity difference between the bonded atoms be between 1.7 to 0.4. Not more than 1.7 and not less than 0.4. The bond will be the polar covalent bond. In polar covalent bond, the electrons are attracted towards the more electronegative atom. That's why they have dipole moment and the electrons are attracted towards the more electronegative atom. So the polarity is induced in this type of bonds. Now let us discuss the properties of the covalent bonds one by one. The covalent compounds have low melting and boiling points, which increases with the increase in the molar or molecular weight of the compound. As the molecular weight increases, the boiling and the melting point of the compound increases. The second property, they are also in crystalline in nature and amorphous in nature. Crystalline is the diamond and amorphous are different proteins, and we say the lipids, these are also covalent compound are amorphous in nature. Further, we will discuss, they form giant structures like diamond. They also form giant structures. Poor conductor of heat and electricity. They do not conduct heat and electricity except graphite. Graphite is the carbon allotrope and it conducts electricity. Mostly found in living organisms. Covalent compounds are mostly found in living organisms and soluble in non-polar solvents and insoluble in the polar solvents. That's all, friends. Let's meet in the next lecture.